What is going on, guys? Welcome to Greggle's TV Daily Rewind. This is where we go back a week and give you your tech news. I'm using a ridiculous filter right now with my Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Don't have a microphone plugged into it like I usually do. It's just the microphone built into the phone, and I'm just holding it in my hand. And anyways, if you watch this show on a weekly basis or it's your first time, we go back and put 7 days of tech news videos into one video. And it was all about the Galaxy Note 10. It was the week it was released. We talk about, you know, phones being delivered and if they're going to be delivered. We talked about the Galaxy Note 10 update that was pushed out and everything that entails, accessories that are up for pre-order. We talk about the OnePlus 7T. We talk about a bunch of stuff. So if you're into this phone, is a great week for all of that stuff. And on a side note, guys, I added, I put a little post about this up too, but if you're in, want to support the channel and show your support for the channel for a little as a buck a month, I started a new exclusive Discord chat where you'll be able to talk to me directly in a chat room along with my other Patreon supporters about tech or anything else that's interesting, and we can get the ball rolling and maybe we can meet some new friends and stuff like that. But it should be cool. Should be exciting. We've already got the ball rolling with that. It's linked down below. And other than that, guys, let me know what your favorite news story is of the week, and I'll see you in the next one. And let me know what you think of this. Does this look cool or not for the Galaxy Note 10 Plus? Let's get into the tech news first story of the day. If you have a Galaxy S10, S10 Plus unlocked version of the phone here in the US, the latest update, the August update, is already out. And I believe it's earlier than even the carrier versions, which is a shocking thing. We've gotten two updates within a month for the Galaxy S10 and S10 Plus unlocked. Check your updates. I already got mine and installed it. Next, let's talk about the shipping information for the Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus. First of all, Sprint, obviously we already have the tracking numbers for those. I've checked them. There's no activity as of yet. Next would be AT&T. One of my viewers reached out to me and they told me that theirs is preparing to ship. I fully expect later on today for that to actually ship out. No later than tomorrow, but probably today. Next up is T-Mobile. A couple of you guys reached out to me, said the money's been taken from your credit card and it says like preparing to ship. Well, I've also have another person that has T-Mobile and theirs is actually already shipped with a tracking number, and it shows that it's going to arrive on the 20th. At least that's what the tracking says from UPS. We'll see if that stands up to be ringing true. Obviously that's tomorrow, but that definitely T-Mobile is already either preparing to ship it out or already has with tracking numbers. And the last two, Verizon and Samsung. For Verizon, I don't have any tracking information or any information as to if those phones have been preparing to ship or anything like that. So I'm thinking they haven't done anything. I'll expect, again, later today for that information to start shipping out. And then lastly, Samsung orders. Unlocked version has begun to ship out, 256 and 512. And those orders are slated to arrive on August 21st. I have the Samsung.com order. I know mine's either already shipped out or will be shipped out later today, just to get based off of me being unable to cancel my order at this point. So that means it's basically already out of the point of either being shipped or has been shipped. So I would expect mine as well to arrive on the 21st from Samsung.com. Also within Samsung.com, I know someone that has the Sprint version that ordered through Samsung.com. That has also been shipped out. Speaking of shipping, over in Dubai, one of my viewers, Karan Veer, hopefully I got your name right, has sent me a picture, and you can see right here, of his Galaxy Note 10 Plus package. It's the 512 gigabyte version, 12 gigabytes of RAM, and they give you that cool looking package that we've seen in the past, I think last year. He might even been the same guy that sent it to me last year. Super cool. I would love it to come in a beautiful package like this. I asked him for more pictures, but at this time of making this video, I'll probably have to insert them into tomorrow's video if he sends them out to me, but this is what it looks like. And lastly, the Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus first software update, when you get the phone, is going to be this. And it's already starting to come out in some places. Here it is. You're gonna see the performance of the fingerprint recognition has been improved. That's one of the big things that has some reviewers have been talking about, is that the fingerprint sensor underneath the display is better than what it's on the S10, S10 Plus. The performance of the touchscreen has been improved, which is awesome. The stability of camera has been improved. The camera picture quality has been improved. Again, those are two things, or whatever. The one thing, the thing has been, people are saying is better, as well as the camera. And also it's been rated as a top rated camera from DxOMark. I know a lot of you guys don't care about that, but it's still a good feat to get. The security of your device has also been improved, which is a no-brainer. It's putting them up to the August security patch. So an awesome first update for the Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus there, as you can see. Let's get into the tech news. First story of the day is about the Note 10, Note 10 Plus wallpaper. There is a subreddit now where you can go, and I'll link it down below, that allows you to download different wallpapers that have the cutout specifically for that camera that's in the middle of the screen, like the Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus. And these will, like I said, take advantage of that to make it a little creative with it. Maybe it'll be someone's eye, or it'll be the hole for a golf course, or just a black dot on a white background, or whatever it may be, just to hide it or make it more creative. I'll link this down below, and you can use these when you get your Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus. Next up, leaker Max J put out a tweet leaking the OnePlus 7T and its launch. So he's saying it's going to be launched September 26th in India, October 10th in the US in Europe. October 15th is when it'll actually go on sale. And that image he's showing is a render. It's not something he's actually know what it's gonna look like, but that's just what he thinks it will look like. Now, if you're not sure what the OnePlus 7T or 7T Pro will end up being, it's just a slightly juiced up or slightly redesigned OnePlus 7 Pro. It'll be slightly better in some ways, not completely, but it will be slightly better. Maybe the design will be a little bit better, or maybe the camera will be slightly better. It's usually not like anything too crazy. But again, if you're waiting to get a one or thinking about getting a OnePlus 7, you might want to wait for this version. And the last story of the day is all the different places, from Samsung.com to all the carriers and Best Buy, shipping updates with that phone. Now, this, I want to first off do two things. Thank you to everyone that's been sending me this information. Obviously, I wouldn't even know it, especially with some of these other carriers that I don't even have. So thank you so much for everyone to send this, tweeting at me, texting me, whatever you, however you're sending it to me. Thank you so much. Second thing is, it might not cover you completely, because obviously you might have ordered it a little bit earlier, a little bit later, but it should cover the mass majority of people. So let's jump into this. First of all, Samsung.com, which I think a lot of you guys ordered through. I know I did. And my order still says August 21st. Delivery, which is tomorrow. I've checked the tracking. I don't see any movement still. I'm assuming it's going to show some movement today. I'm assuming at this point they have to overnight it, obviously, unless it's getting pushed back further. But I fully expect the phone to arrive August 21st. I already did receive one of my accessories. It was the Galaxy Watch Active. So I've received that so far. But it looks like Samsung.com orders, the earliest we're going to get it is August 21st if you've had tracking already for it. Next is Sprint, again, August 21st. The initial tracking numbers that I've received from people that said the 19th, those still don't show any movement. So at this point, it's August 21st. T-Mobile is still August 20th and 21st. The person that gave me the information for the 20th, I'm having trouble finding their name, but that yesterday, if you watched that show, someone said, and I had a screenshot of it, saying August 20th, that is when it would be delivered. I don't have a tracking number to actually check that, because they just sent me a screenshot showing T-Mobile, blah, 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 blah. But I would go 20th, 21st as the earliest T-Mobile is going to get deliveries, because I've seen a lot of people with the 21st delivery date. Verizon, you're looking at August 21st for some people, August 22nd for others. It seems like I've noticed some of the people that have the 5G version are getting it on the 22nd, so a day later. And then it seems like the LTE people are getting it on the 21st. You can fix me down below if that's a little bit wrong, if any of you 5G people are getting it on the 21st. But again, the earliest, August 21st, or a little bit later, the August 22nd. Next up is AT&T. AT&T is in a very similar boat. August 21st, August 22nd. It just depends how early or late you ended up ordering it, but I've seen people with both order dates, August 21st to August 22nd, and obviously that's tomorrow and the next day. And lastly, Best Buy. I haven't seen any movement on that. My suggestion to you guys is, next time there's a pre-order, I would not order through Best Buy. I did in the past, and either it was delayed massively, and I could order, and then, like, when I found that out, I ended up ordering it through somebody else and it came much faster. So I would really only use Best Buy if they actually have the phone in stock. I probably wouldn't use them for pre-orders. Probably should have told you that to you guys, but yeah, Best Buy is kind of a bad place to pre-order. I mean, you might still get it on the 23rd, but generally you don't get it early, and generally it's delayed a lot of times, even when the phone's not sold out other places. As for other carriers like Comcast and or Xfinity and some of the other places, I know some of those people are still going to get it on like the 21st, 22nd, 23rd, somewhere in that range. I just don't have a lot of information because a lot of you guys don't have those carriers. But yeah, that's basically what we have so far for these carriers. Let's get into the tech news. First story of the day is when you get your Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus, ever be today, the next day, or whatever, the update should be pushed out, the one I talked about yesterday. At least it is for Verizon. And this update, I spoke about this, I don't know, 2 days ago. The update that's going to allow you to improve the performance of the fingerprint sensor, the performance of touchscreen, stability of the camera, camera picture quality, and the security of the device overall is being pushed out for Verizon right now. It also gives you security patch August 1st, 2019. So it's a really, really nice update with improved things such as the camera and the fingerprint. You'll definitely want to download this. If you get it for another carrier, then you're going to want to also check for it anyway. You'll probably have it, but I know Verizon definitely has it right now. These aren't available just yet for the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus, but they will be, and it will be through the Samsung store. And once they are, I'll let you guys know, I'll link it. But regardless, this is going to be, if you're a Marvel fan, you're gonna be in love with this. You'll be able to get all of these Marvel cases. And the cool thing is they have an NFC chip built into the case, which will allow you to download a free, looks like theme slash wallpaper for, definitely wallpaper, but it looks like theme as well. So you can match it up to your case, Captain America, Iron Man, Deadpool, and Spider-Man. And lastly, the shipping update for everyone's phones. At this point, it looks like everyone has shipped their phones, and by that I mean everybody from Best Buy, Samsung.com, all the four carriers here in the United States, T-Mobile, Verizon, Sprint, AT&T, and now it's just a point of when you're gonna get it. It's kind of a mixed bag at that point as well. It seems like basically almost every place and carrier is gonna get it to you by August 21st, if not August 22nd. Again, it's just kind of a mixed bag if you don't, if you order a little bit late, a little bit early. It seems like most Best Buy orders are still August 22nd. But then after that, again, it's kind of a mixed bag. I know a lot of people's phones are on the delivery truck right now. So if you have this phone, you should be getting it delivered today, a lot of you people. I know some, again, I know some people the 22nd and then some people even beyond that, but the greater majority of the messages that I've been getting have been on the delivery truck right now, August 21st, and then tomorrow as well, August 22nd. So definitely, you probably wanna be home for this because you're most likely going to have to sign. So you're gonna either have to, if you miss your delivery, you'll have to call FedEx or UPS and ask them to set up arrangements so you can pick it up. If you're not able to be there for delivery, I'm gonna have to make sure I hear my doorbell and don't leave the house too. They usually come in the middle of the day for me, it seems like. So I'll make sure that I'm wide awake and that I'm waiting for that so I don't miss my delivery. And your accessories should be out there and all that stuff. So very, very cool. The other part of this is once you get your phone, send me some pictures of you holding it up and I'll show it in tomorrow's video. And speaking of people getting their phone, this came from Montreal, a guy named Reed. Thank you, Reed, for sending this over to me. And it's his Galaxy Note 10. He actually received it yesterday. It's the 512 gigabyte version, 6.8 inch. And he got the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, like I said. And they also got a free promo for Galaxy Buds. They didn't get a $150 thing for free, but they did get $130 Galaxy Buds. Looks like he chose the black one. So thanks for that, Reed. Let's get into the tech news. First story of the day is a new Google Home Mini is soon to come out. It'll be called the Nest Home Mini, and this is an exclusive from 9to5 Google. I'll link the story down below if you want to read the whole story, but you can see the headline. Google plans second generation Nest Mini, aka Google Home Mini, with built-in wall mount, which will allow you obviously to mount it to a wall easier. Better sound, so the speaker will be bigger and louder, and an aux jack, which is a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, so if you wanna hook that up to a bigger speaker, you can. Now, there's no news on price or release date, but I would assume come this holiday season, you should be able to see this and buy this. Next up, if you have the Samsung Galaxy Buds, which are the completely wireless buds that Samsung put out earlier this year, there is a new update out, and the update allows you to stabilize Bluetooth connection through added fixes. Now, it doesn't go into depth about what that fix actually does. To me, it probably just makes the Bluetooth connection between the headphones and the phone or whatever device you're listening to stronger, so there's less cutout. That still seems to be a little bit of an issue with true wireless earbuds, almost all of them at times. So it probably, again, just fixes that, which it has fixed it in the past, but again, it probably just further strengthens it. Next up, I did get my Galaxy Note 10 Plus 512 gigabyte black version, and if you want to see the video on that, I'll link that down below. It already released it this morning. This is just a PSA that the update has also come out for the locked version, and the locked update version is the same as ones we've talked about the last couple of days, which is the performance of fingerprint recognition, touchscreen has been improved, stability of camera picture quality, security of the device has been improved. Again, this update is out right this second. Right when I woke up this morning, I had the update, so it was right there. It should also be there for the other carrier versions as well. I know Verizon already has it. I would not be surprised. I haven't seen any news on it, but I would not be surprised if T-Mobile, Sprint, and AT&T also have the same update. So just go into settings and then go into software update and you should have it. If you're looking to buy the Galaxy Note 10 Plus or Note 10 and you have extra money, like you don't have to finance it if you don't want to, and you don't want to pay tax, I was looking up, Swap is actually a great place to buy the phone in terms of that. You can get it brand new for low 900s right now for the 256 gigabyte version. And again, there's no tax on that. So you're gonna end up saving, what, 150, 200 bucks total after tax, because again, there's no tax on the swapper price. So if you have a little bit of money saved, I would definitely recommend buying it through that. You swap all the time with stuff, even when I sell my own devices. So it's a legit site. It's backed by PayPal and all that. So again, check it out, link down below. Let's get into the tech news. If you've been following my channel the last week or so, there's been a rumor and official confirmation that OnePlus will be releasing a OnePlus television. That's right, a smart television. Well, we've got a little bit more information on that television. It looks like they're going to be using their OnePlus TV will sport a Samsung QLED panel. Now, the Samsung QLED panels are fairly expensive in terms of the price that Samsung sells their TVs at, you know, over $1,000 for sure, and then sometimes even more than that. So in OnePlus, as you know, usually releases budget price items with really good specs. So I have a lot of hope for this. It's going to be an amazing TV, amazing looking TV that has built-in Android TV as well at a really reasonable price. When more information about this comes out, I'll let you guys know, but this should and probably will be a really nice looking TV. Another past story that I worked on maybe a week or two ago at this point was the availability and information about the 1 terabyte version of the Galaxy Note 10 5G. Well, I got another picture from Mr. D's product review channel, and this photo that he sent over to me, as you can see, under Galaxy Note 10 5G, it shows a price of $1,599.99 for the 1 terabyte, 12 gigabytes of RAM version of the Galaxy Note 10 Plus 5G. There's been no official confirmation that a 1 terabyte version is coming out, but now that it's showing a price and information about it, I can't see that they won't do this at a later date. Is it needed? Probably not, but it looks, all signs are indicating that it's probably gonna come out. Next up, if you've been wanting to pre-order the Galaxy Tab S6, you now officially can. I'll link it down below if they do all my stories, but it's officially available for pre-order on Samsung's website for $649 and $729 for the 256 gigabyte version. The other one's the 128. You can get it in Wi-Fi. They don't have the LTE models available for pre-order just yet. It does come in the colors of cloud blue, mountain gray, and rose blush with a 10.5-inch screen. Their special offer on this is that you can get the keyboard cover case, which has a trackpad on it as well, for half price at 90 bucks. And again, this is available for pre-order right now. You can also pre-order their S Pens for this device, which are big and lush, and those go for 60 bucks, and those are available in all colors as well. And the last story of the day is Samsung Galaxy S Pens are officially up for order, not pre-order, but actually order. They're 30 bucks a piece and they're the Note 10 version of this. And again, $30 right now, and get them in any color you want. Have it be black, blue, or gray. And if so, if you want to mix and match, maybe you have a black phone, but you want the blue pen or vice versa, you now can get that. $30 available right now, linked down below as well. Let's get into the tech news. First story of the day is that the OnePlus 7T, the successor to the OnePlus 7 Pro, has leaked out. And this comes from OnLeaks is a leaker in the community, and he's leaked this out, and he's leaked a bunch of phones previously as well, and has a really, really good track record. And as you can see, this phone, especially on the front anyway, looks really, really similar to the OnePlus 6T with that teardrop design for the display, unlike what we got with the OnePlus 7 Pro. OnePlus 7 Pro has a all screen, and then the camera pops out from the top mechanically. I guess it's a choice of which one you would like better. I guess I like the other design better. I don't use the front camera that much, enough to where I need it to pop out 100 times a day. So it probably wouldn't bother me. I'd rather have all display rather than the teardrop. But anyways, that's what it looks like on the front. The back is really interesting as well. You can see it almost looks like a kind of an animal of some sort. You get three cameras across from each other, but they're like triangled in around a circle with a flash below that, OnePlus logo below that. So very interesting just look to this phone. The button layout is the same in terms of where they are on the left and on the right from previous phones as well. And then a speaker at the bottom, USB-C, and also the SIM card slot. But yeah, that's what the new OnePlus 7T will look like. It should be out either in September or October at the very latest. Goldstein 1997 over on Reddit has a post where he has said, spotted the Galaxy Fold in the wild on the train. It is now a fixed one. The guy was kind enough to let me get a quick hands-on, but only this image. And the image he shows is, it's kind of far away. It almost looks like a small tablet. And that's really what the Galaxy Fold is like a small tablet, 7-inch display, or 7.3-inch display when it's completely wide open. And I believe it's 4.6 when it's closed up, but he didn't really say much about it. He did say it's very satisfying to open and close it, but other than that, he said this is the Galaxy Fold. So if you're excited about this, it's supposed to be, all rumors are indicating it's going to be out in September at some point for people to be able to purchase. And the last story of the day is, if you have the Galaxy Note 10 or Note 10 Plus, you obviously know there's no headphone jack. And if you want to use your old headphones or even a 3.5 millimeter microphone like I do sometimes when I make my videos, you're gonna have to get an adapter, the dongle, basically the dongle that plugs into the USB-C and then has a headphone jack at the end. Well, before you go out and just buy any random one, it looks like some of the ones that have been released so far from Samsung for other devices like the Tab 5e are incompatible with the Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus. So I would recommend, like I did today because I forgot to earlier, to buy the official one from Samsung's site. I linked it down below, and it's $15, unfortunately, but it's gonna give you the ability to have any headphone jack or headphone adapter, you know, 3.5 millimeter, work with it on your new Galaxy Note 10, Note 10 Plus. The reviews on there are bad, but if you look at the reviews, it's just people complaining. Those are the bad reviews. The good reviews are actually saying some interesting or good stuff. So basically, there's one review that says, I picked this up from Best Buy today since it was to be shipped on September 6th, ordered off their website. I compared it to the Pixel 3 dongle, and there's actually some good sound improvement, which I'm assuming it's because of the built-in DAC. It outputs more volume to worth it. So again, I would recommend getting the official one from Samsung at that point. Let's get into the tech news. First story of the day is Google Photos. And you should be using Google Photos, especially if you use Android, and probably if you use iPhone as well. And Google Photos backs up all your photos into one spot, unlimited backup of photos and videos. And they're coming out with a really, really cool feature this month. Now, Ken Durek found this. He said, I also just discovered it does OCR on everything uploaded. Now, basically what that means is you type in a word and it searches your photos for that word, and it'll bring up any photos that have that word in it, as you can see right here. awesome feature. So think of it in many different ways. As you can see from the tweet here from Google Photos, they responded back to him saying, "You spotted it. Starting this month, we're rolling out the ability to search your photos by the text in them. Once you find the photo you're looking for, click the lens button to easily copy and paste text. Take that, impossible Wi-Fi passwords." This is an amazing little thing here. I mean, it's so simple in terms of its actual act, but it's a really cool feature in terms of being able to search for text. There's tons of times I take a picture of something and I just wanna search via the text to remember something about it, and this is gonna work awesome sometime during this month. And the last story of the day, if you remember from the keynote, the Note 10 and Note 10 Plus now have 3D scanning, and it didn't have it at launch, at least I didn't see it, and you have to download the app separately, and that's the big news. You can now download the app. I have it linked down below, so click on that link, and then once you go to that link, what you want to do, it's going to bring you into the Galaxy App Store. At the top, search for 3D scanner, just like I have there. Hit search, and then you'll see the app. Download that app and open it up, and you can scan it. Basically, almost anything, as you can see some of the things right here. Pretty cool stuff. I don't know, you can have a lot of fun with the 3D scanner on the Note 10, Note 10 Plus. Thanks for watching, guys. Your question of the day is, what is your three top favorite features of the Galaxy Note 10 Plus thus far? Let me know in the comments down below. I'll keep mine a secret because I'm gonna put it in a video eventually, soon. Thanks for watching. See you guys down the road. Peace.